When the African Union summit got underway in the marbled hallways in the capital of Kigali, top on the agenda was the election of the AU Commission chairperson to replace Dlamini Zuma, who had served 4 years at the helm. Uganda chose Dr. Wandira Kazibwe, a woman who had shattered the glass ceiling as the first female vice president in Africa, with a stellar academic record as a surgeon, later serving a PhD in public health at the prestigious Harvard University. Like the rest of the other competitors, Kazibwe needed at least 34 votes from the 53 voting states to secure this position. However, the old politics of regional bloc hegemony and shambolic campaign conspired against Kazibwe.
Numbers, they have numbers. Numbers, because the EAC, we are only now 6 countries, including South Sudan. But if you look at the SADC, there are more and more, so many countries in SADC, you know, they range from Democratic Republic of Congo, South Africa, even the economic power they have. Look at the SADC region alone, South Africa, Botswana, Zimbabwe, Malawi, you know, the entire, the SADC region alone has so much economic power that they have a leverage in terms of the decisions that are made at the AU level. If those blocs don't believe in you as a candidate, you'll have a difficult process convincing them to vote for you. And I do believe that's why ECOWAS became difficult in terms of the processes of Dr. Kazibwe being elected.
The ECOWAS bloc of the African Union carries with it 15 members. So does the South African Development Community. The East African Community, where Kazibwe hails from, has just 6 member states. The rest of the seats are occupied by the Northern African countries. So did Uganda attempt to punch above its own weight? Public policy analyst Dismas Nkunda says Kazibwe was a good choice, but she was poorly marketed for the job.
As a person, she was qualified, but the point was, how did we present the candidate to the rest of the continent?
Analysts argue that from the onset, the presentation of Kazibwe as a candidate for the East African region undercut her leverage in the more influential regional blocs.
If she had come in as Dr. Speciosa Kazibwe and not as a candidate of Uganda, then that was going to be a different matter, because she should have gotten advice from a wide range of individuals who understand the structures of the AU. But
her close relationship with the president, together with the process in which she was selected to lead the East African charge, would also be another point of contention in her vote search.
You know, the general picture about what people have about Uganda was blotted, and then we are fronting a candidate who the entire state machinery is campaigning for. It doesn't argue well for her, because everybody looks through it and says Museveni is pushing for his own agenda on the African continent.
Kazibwe's public office record, dogged with a trail of scandals, gave her rivals ammunition to go with.
She had quite a lot of a bit in the closet. Skeleton is in the closet. That how did she deal with those corruption scandals? Did she come out clean? Was she given clearance by the IGG? What was what ultimately came out? You know, some of that information, you can't hide it away. It's there in the public. It's on the internet that she was involved in those scandals.
At the height of her campaign, the government forked out 1 billion shillings to fund her. And while public opinion argued against the move, Nkunda says, comparatively, it was a no match with the other candidates in the race.
She was given $1 million to go and campaign. Her biggest opponent, the gentleman from Equatorial Guinea, had $10 million.
He reveals that the country could have adopted other strategies.
Needed to invest in not only in money, in giving her money, investing in the processes, investing in understanding how to convince the rest of the continent that actually Dr. Speciosa Kazibwe was not bringing interests of Uganda, but the interests of the continent.
Kazibwe lost the first round of voting at the AU summit, scoring just 11 votes, coming last. But her two rivals did not score enough votes to outrightly win with a two-thirds majority. The next round of voting will take place in January next year, and Kazibwe will still be eligible to contest. Raymond Mujuni, NTV.